Hello, welcome to our short video on how to design a half-wave rectifier circuit. This schematic represents a half-wave rectifier circuit. A half-wave rectifier circuit inverts and transfers only the negative half of a time-varying input signal to its output. Half-wave rectifiers are commonly used with other op-amp circuits, such as peak detectors or bandwidth-limited non-inverting amplifiers, to produce a DC output voltage. The transfer function of this circuit is given by the equation for the output voltage, VO. The input signal, VI, is amplified by negative RF divided by R1, but only for negative values of VI. For positive values of VI, the output should be zero. The design goal of this circuit is to input a bipolar signal from plus minus 0.2 millivolts peak to peak to plus minus 4 volts peak to peak, and convert it to a unipolar signal from 0.1 to 2 volts peak. It utilizes a dual plus minus 2.5 volt supply. To design this circuit, we will analyze it with both a positive input signal and then a negative input signal. First, we will analyze the circuit for a positive input signal. Positive input signals will forward bias SD2 and reverse bias SD1. Therefore, SD2 is represented as a short circuit and SD1 is represented as an open circuit. In this configuration, the output is 0 volts. Next, we will analyze the circuit for negative input signals. Negative input signals reverse bias SD2 and forward bias SD1. Therefore, SD2 is represented as an open circuit, and SD1 is represented as a short circuit. The circuit is now in an inverting configuration, so the output is equal to negative RF divided by R1 times the input voltage, VI. Setting RF equal to R1 produces a gain of minus 1 volt per volt. For this circuit, we will select standard 750 ohm resistors for RF and R1. A transient analysis of this circuit with a 1 kHz, 200 millivolt peak-to-peak sinusoidal input yields a half-wave rectified output signal with an amplitude of 100 millivolts peak. A transient analysis of this circuit with a 50 kHz, 4 volt peak-to-peak sinusoidal input yields a half-wave rectified output signal with an amplitude of 2 volts peak. When designing a half-wave rectifier circuit, there are a few design notes to be aware of. First, be sure to use an op-amp with a high slew rate. When the input signal changes polarities, the amplifier output must slew 2 diode drops. Next, be sure to use fast switching diodes. Schottky diodes might be a preferable choice, since they have faster transitions than PN junction diodes, but this comes at the expense of higher reverse leakage. Finally, minimize noise by selecting low-value resistors. Texas Instruments has many online resources to help you design circuits with op-amps. This includes reference designs and guides, educational videos, simulation and prototyping tools, support resources, and search tools. Thank you for taking the time to watch this short presentation on how to design a half-wave rectifier circuit. Please visit www.ti.com for additional information and resources.